Well, Alan, Preston for Swansea City this weekend, obviously a game which brings back so many memories in the club's history, that promotion in 1981, and you were part of that side. You know, what a great day and what fond memories you must have of it.
Yeah, I mean, it's still as vivid as ever, 38 years ago now, which is quite scary in itself. But yeah, I mean, I remember just about everything, but the whole weekend, you know, actually travelling up on the Friday, getting to the game, you know, seeing all the, I think we took 10,000 supporters, but I'm sure I've spoken to about 20,000 people who said that they were there. You know, just arriving at the game and just, you know, just everywhere was where I was supporters. And obviously the meaning of the game as well, you know, that we knew that, which was a great knowledge to have, that if we won the game, then we were going to get promoted. But still the nerves were kicking in, because first time the club would ever have played in that top flight. Yeah, and as I say, it's all still so very vivid. Bill Shankly was there. You know, people, you know, watching the game, Gareth Edwards and Mike England, I remember being there, and, you know, all these sort of, you know, like prominent Welsh sports people as well, as, you know, so it was, it almost became more of a game, really, than, you know, just getting promotion. It was really, I guess it was a club on a mission to get to the top flight for the first time.
Yeah, what was the mood like in the city that week? You know, I think you drew with Luton in the midweek to set it up as a game. You knew that if you won, you'd be promoted ahead of Blackburn. What was it like?
Well, we were disappointed initially, talking about the Luton game, because obviously if we'd have won the game, we'd have been that much closer. But we'd have meant that we would have gone to Preston, I think, and maybe just needed a point. But maybe thinking back, it was probably better that we knew that if we were to win there, then, you know, there was, you know, no coming back from there. Yeah, I mean, the mood, it as you can imagine, you know, everybody, you know, you walk in the street, or, you know, you buy a paper, or you, whatever you went, you know, there were people wishing you all the best. And because they had beaten Preston, had beaten us as well in the 64 FA Cup semi-final. And I mean, I think we beat them twice in the league that year, but to lose in the semi-final of an FA Cup was a real bitter pill for people. So again, that was another thing, you know, another sort of extra incentive for us to do well. Try and right the wrongs, and but, you know, but the most important thing, to win the game, to get into the First Division.
Yeah, I mean, you mentioned Bill Shankly there, obviously John Toshak, manager at the time. Alan, is it right you trained at Melwood before the game, and then Shankly gave you a team talk before you went out?
Well, whenever we played up north, and Bill Shankly would invariably come to the hotel, you know, and he would come for pre-match, and he did a lot of team talks. I mean, Tosh obviously would give the main talks, but, you know, he would just speak to the players individually sometimes. And then collectively, you know, and I remember him saying, you know, how important it was for us to, you know, like, with all the amount of people there, you know, the 10,000 people or so, they're coming up to support you and make sure that you don't let them down. So, you know, when somebody like Bill Shankly tells you that, you know, we knew anyway that, you know, we didn't want to let anybody down. But when Bill Shankly reinforces that, then, you know, I think that gave us an extra bit of a fillip. But it was always great to see him, because he was such an iconic figure.
Yeah. And the game itself, you know, obviously got off to a great start. You know, Leighton's goal, you know, one of the iconic Swans goals, cutting in from the right. And you were involved in the build-up to that, Alan.
Yeah, I mean, all I did was pass it to him. It was handy, sort of, you know, it was all Leighton's work, to be honest with you. But Leighton was capable of doing that, you know, and he did it, you know, throughout that campaign. But as I say, he picked the ball up on the left, and then he cut inside, and then he just curled, you know, a fantastic goal into. We started off quite nervously, I think, but, you know, the goal really seemed to settle us down. And from there until the, you know, till the half-time, then we played some really good stuff. You know, we got a real good stranglehold on the game. And, of course, we got the second goal as well. And I think Tommy Craig. So, you know, going in at 2-0, you know, we're in a really good, strong position, knowing that there's always 45 minutes to go. And Preston, I think that at the time that they were trying to fight, trying to avoid relegation. So you knew that, you know, second half they were probably going to come just as determined, because it was the last game for everybody. But you say going into half time, we were in a real good spirit there, 2-0 up, and playing some really good stuff.
Yeah, I mean, Tommy Craig's selection is quite an interesting one, is it? Because John Mahan, he'd been in the side up until that point, I think, Alan, and he was John Toshak's cousin, and he had to leave his cousin out. Yeah, play Tommy, and he scored.
I think Tosh has always said that was one of the most difficult decisions he's ever had to make in football. And when you consider, and that's at the end of his career, although probably John thinks he hasn't finished come to the end yet. But he always said that, you know, never mind Real Madrid, you know, the Real Madrids and all the other clubs that that he managed, that was one of the most difficult decisions. Not only because John was his cousin, but the fact that John was such a very good player as well.
And then obviously, you say Preston's pulled the goal back. And then later on, the clinching goal and the breakout,
yeah.
You leading it on to Robbie James, and then you know, Jeremy Charles' left foot finish. What a moment.
Yeah, it was. I mean, as I say, they came back into the game, you know, which we knew that we knew at halftime that they were going to come back. They pulled one back, you know, 2-1, and then they put all sorts of pressure, and they had so many chances. I remember they had a big centre-half, Baxter. He had a header from a corner, which he put, I thought it had gone through the net. It looked as if it had gone in. And then, you know, sort of, it probably just G'd us up a little bit because, you know, then, as I say, we made the break. I made the break down the right. A little bit lucky, you know, sort of gone through a couple of tackles, and then he sort of passed it on to Robbie. Unusual for Robbie, he actually sort of lost control a little bit, but he still, you know, was strong enough and good enough to reclaim the ball. And we passed it on to Jeremy, and I mean, I'm pretty sure that was correct that, you know, we all shouted, like, just smash it into the stand because, you know, just wasted a little bit of time because he was on his left foot anyway. But, of course, he never listened to us anyway and he smacked it into the back of the net. And 3-1 with a couple of minutes to go, then we knew more or less that that was going to be us promoted. And it was a lovely feeling those last couple of minutes because, you know, I think the Preston had really, you know, been deflated with a goal. And I wouldn't say we were able to coast in, but you know that, you know, with a minute or so to go, then it was game over.
And what are the emotions then? Are they, is it elation, relief, a mixture?
It's a mixture of everything. Yeah, I mean, it's obviously great relief, great happiness. I think as well that the fact that, you know, we were all sort of, you know, we all knew each other. The majority of the players, I think we know 6 or 7 of the boys were local anyway, you know, we'd all grown up together. A plus of the ones as well, Jimmy Aziabdic, Dave Stewart, God rest his soul, Neil Robinson and Tommy, you know, they had all sort of come into the club and really sort of integrated themselves. So it was a really sort of tight atmosphere, and you can imagine the joy that there was at the end of it, not only for us as players, but for the club and obviously all the supporters, those who travel and those back home.
And how did you celebrate it, dare I ask? What was the celebration?
It went on for days, to be honest with you. It went on for days. We, believe it or not, we actually, you know, by the time we left the ground, which obviously took a long, long time, then it was a goal. We actually went to Liverpool. We went to the Holiday Inn in Liverpool for some reason. And the Liverpool players were there. I remember seeing Dalglish was there and Souness was there and Tosh was obviously loving all that type of thing. But we were desperate to go back to Swansea. By the time we got back to Swansea, it's probably the early hours of the morning then. And but to be fair, even, you know, 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, and there were still a couple of hundred supporters waiting for us. And then that shows how relaxed it was in those days. You know, we'd obviously drink champagne and beer and wine, and then we went to the Bayview just down the road, and we stayed there until probably till about 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock in the morning. Eventually get home, but then believe it or not, you get a phone call from Tosh. No mobile phones in those days, to say that we've all got a report back to the Vetch at, I think it's 12 o'clock, to go up to Cardiff to record a BBC Wales programme on us getting promoted. And the majority of the boys are there, but if you look at it, there's no Wyndham Evans, there's no Nigel Stevenson. The both of them were still in the pub there. And I think the first that they knew about it is when they actually saw it up on the screen, where they should have been. But no, we had a great, you know, we celebrated. We came back, I think we carried on the celebrations on the Sunday, probably into the Monday, and I think we had a Welsh Cup final against Hereford either the Monday or the Tuesday. But thankfully, you know, there was still enough legs there to, and I think we actually won the game 1-0. So, but it was a great, you know, it was a great end into a fantastic weekend.
And you had the bus parade as well, I think, to round it off on down to the Guildhall as well, didn't you?
Yeah, again, you know, you look at it now to see the amount of people. Again, very similar, you know, where we went up to the Premier League. But it was great to actually be on the bus and to celebrate, because the first time, as I say, ever the club had ever been in the top flight. So, as I say, again, it was a really special moment for us as players. But I think, you know, we shared the joy with everybody in the city, and obviously it was fantastic for the club as well.
Yeah, and going back to Deepdale this weekend, I mean, obviously the ground's very different now, but yeah. does it just bring it all back to you?
Yeah, I think I've only been there probably back there once. And again, you know, even then it changed, and that's going back quite a while. But yeah, I mean, you know, you'll try to sort of take it all in again, you know, and the surroundings, you know, they've all changed, all the stadiums have changed, or they've moved stadiums like ourselves. But no, there'll still definitely be that sort of little bit of reflection when we go back there. Really looking forward to going back, you know, just for the fact that it'll be 38 years ago, which sounds crazy when you say it. So I'm looking forward to being at the game. Obviously, we've got our own reasons for going there to try and get 3 points, but certainly in the back of mind will be, you know, this is the place where, you know, probably one of the best moments of my entire career.
And you talked about the influence of the local players in that side you played in, Alan. Obviously, Joe Roden and Connor Roberts coming through, making their own impact this season. You know, how much does it please you to see local talent making its presence felt?
Yeah, I mean, it was obviously a big strength of you know the team that I played in, is that we were all, you know, all from the locality and we all knew each other, and you know, we I think that we bonded, and I think that it's so important. You know, as much as we love to sign, you know, the Gilfies and the Michus and the Wilfred Bonies, you know, it's fantastic to see Joe Roden coming through and Connor coming through and Dan James coming through and Ollie coming through. Like Matty Grimes has sort of come through the ranks, and even though he's not our player, but, you know, originally, but, you know, they're all coming through now. And I think it's great to see. And I think the crowd can identify with one of their own then. And, you know, I think it's been, you know, one of the successes, one of the huge successes of this season is the emergence of these local players, and it's great to see.
And just on yourself, and obviously back in the first team coaching staff under Graham Potter, just how much have you enjoyed that?
Yeah, I mean, it's been great. I mean, I obviously thought that, you know, the coaching days were over. I mean, to be honest, I mean, you know, I'm more of a backup to Graham, you know, in terms of, you know, you probably watch rather than actually do the coaching itself. But no, it's great to be involved. Obviously, you're there on the touchline, you know, you're on the bench as well for the you know, the games home and away. And it's great to be sort of, to feel part of it again. And, you know, and you know, so looking forward to Saturday, you know, especially the last couple of games, you know, we've had some great results, we're scoring goals, but, you know, there's a good feel about the team. And, you know, if we can carry that on with 20 games to go, then, you know, that those playoffs, you know, are a distinct possibility. And I think once we get to the playoffs, and I think that we're the type of team that nobody particularly wants to play against. And obviously a little bit of strengthening wouldn't go amiss. But, you know, the team looks really sort of settled at the moment, and looking for big things, you know, between now and the end of the season.